Today we're talking about membrane roofs. What materials are there to choose from? Where do you put the insulation? How do you find a leak and how do you fix a leak? All key things to think about when designing a membrane roof. There's lots of different chemistries in membranes, and I'm not going to really get into all of them today, but just know that there are a broad class of membranes you can choose from. There's bitumen-based ones. They'll take oil from the ground, mix it with some chemicals to give it some stability and structure, impregnate some felt or grit inside of that to give it some more strength. That's broadly kind of SBS, APPs, APAOs, long track record on those. Lots of good chemistry and lots of different characteristics you can get from those additives. Then you've got some of the synthetic single plies, KEEs, TPOs, PVCs. Really easy to roll these out on large areas. They come in big 2 meter widths, heat welded together. These can be really cost effective single plies if you've got really large areas. A little bit harder to detail around some of the corners, a little bit harder to maintain in the future, but also a very good option in certain applications. You've got EPDM, which is also a rubberized product, a single ply sheet good, adhered at the side of the sides, good option in a lot of applications. You've also got liquid applieds or hot rubbers that go down as liquid, monolithic, no seams, really good option in protected membrane assemblies, something to look at. Now, which one of these is the best? We ask this question all the time, and unfortunately, there's not really a straight answer. It really depends on a lot of different factors. Some of these factors you might think about: the movement, what's your budget, what's the temperature change you're gonna go through, what kind of details do you have? Are they complex details? What's the risk of things below you? If there is a leak, is it gonna be really problematic, or can you, go and fix it? The contractor's ability to install these, something else to consider. You don't want somebody installing something for the first time. So ask your contractor what they've installed before, what are they familiar with, and what would they recommend can be a really good way to do it. Also, your ability to maintain these, something to consider. You want a really long lifespan on these membranes. You want to pick one that can be maintained. Where you put the insulation in that assembly is also something to think about. If you install it in a cold roof application, you've got insulation at the ceiling line and your membrane is above your cold attic space. That has some condensation concerns, which you should be aware of. Either condensation or moisture coming from below in the house or even from venting can cause some problems in those types of roofs. A more robust option would be a warm roof where you move insulation up above the structure, membrane on top of that. Warm roof, conventional roof, that's been done for a number of years very successfully. You do need to think about if water does get past that membrane, what happens to it? Is it gonna accumulate in there? What's the consequences of that? But still a very good option. Another option becoming more popular is a protected membrane roof where your membrane's applied down to the structure, insulation moved above the membrane. That keeps your membrane at a nice stable temperature year round. And it gives you a nice bonding surface to the substrate. So those three places you can put insulation, all of them have some costs and benefits associated. And just think about that when you're designing your roof. When a membrane roof leaks, because it will, eventually it will leak, you need to have a think about how fast or what's the urgency to know about that leak. So there's a few different ways you can uncover these leaks before they actually drip through the building or start to cause structural damage. One thing you can do during construction or on some sort of annual basis is roof membrane integrity scanning. This can be done with low voltage or high voltage. There's a number of suppliers around the market. Essentially, you're applying a current through the roof membrane to see if there's a bridge or a path for electricity to flow through the membrane. That can be something to do on a spot basis during construction or during maintenance cycles. If you'd like to know about the leak a little bit faster, you can install sensors inside the roof. That will either trigger an alarm or a dashboard to tell you that there's water in this roof, go up and have a look at it. Another really simple thing you can do on warm roofs to check for leaks is infrared scanning. If you go during sunset, all the membrane will be the same temperature, but as that sun goes away, the dry areas will cool off quicker than the wet areas. And you'll be able to see that temperature difference and see if there's wet areas of insulation. So those can be three kind of quick ways to look for leaks and think about how you're going to continually monitor for leaks. So a few key takeaways from today: there's different materials you can look at and all of them do very different things. And depending on your application, one's gonna be right for you. Where you put the insulation in regards to your membrane, that can be another design consideration that you need to keep in mind. And what's another thing to think about is the leak monitoring. How are you gonna check for leaks? How are you gonna monitor and maintain this roof membrane? That gives you a really brief overview of some of the things to think about when you're designing a roof membrane system. Don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe on the channel. We'll see you next time.